Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm continuing with the topic LangChain use cases. We are going to describe how to do a Q&A system. As usual, I prepare a notebook that I will later post to the repository, and I will cover some of the typical cases that we can use a Q&A system, how to do it, and which components we basically need. No? As usual, I provide you a number of links where you can find detailed information about the topic. And probably the most important, or the more the one that you will use the most, is this the own LangChain documentation, which is pretty well explained how to do it. You can go through, explain what is, how you can create, and the different options that have. We will not cover even all the possibilities that they have LangChain even in the documentation. So as usual, again, I'm working with Colab Pro. We don't need a GPU for this tutorial. We install the libraries we need. Today we will use a vector database. In this case, we will use Chroma for this example. You can use others like Pinecone or Faiss or even Neo4j. But for this simple experiment, we will just use a simple one. It's freeware. You can use it. And then for the purpose of this tutorial, is more than enough. We just connect the drive. In the drive, I had two documents that I will use for this exercise. We connect to the OpenAI. And here, the simple example, the most simple QA system, is just acts directly to the LLM with a prompt, no? And give an instruction to answer a question that you provide, no? In this case, I'm going to do something a little bit more sophisticated, based in one of the techniques that we had in prompt engineering. Is here I put you the link, is generate knowledge prompting, where you add some knowledge in the prompt to help the LLM to answer correctly the question. You can read, go through how works this exactly, this technique, but essentially is that you get a context, it's and you help provide some additional information to the LLM. Probably the LLM is able in this case to answer the question without the help of the context, but we add this context and we narrow the information that the LLM is using to provide a question. Here, as you say, we answer in the instruction is answering the question in detail the answer. The context is something about how golf is working. I'm not a professional in golf, and even I probably play one time in my life, so I don't know too much about golf. And then on, well, we prepare the question. Part of the goal is trying to get the highest point total than others, yes or not. And here you just simply, sorry, probably I miss, yeah, exactly, I miss this. And you just create a template, a prompt template. It looks like this, and then we call the LLM. Again, we are using here OpenAI. It's up to you. You can change the LLM. It's just plug and play. You can choose another one like Llama or whatever you want to use. We need generate embeddings in this case, so choose one that is you have possibility to generate embeddings. You can use Llama like we did in previous videos, and in this case, we are not focusing on the LLM, we are focusing in LangChain, so that's why I'm using this, but it's up to you which LLM you want to use. Here the answer is no, it's obviously no, because it's not the purpose of the goal to get more points than the other participants, it's just to complete the I don't know what is the name, the holes with less strokes than the other participants. Here now we are going to use embeddings. As I said, we are going to, before we are going to use a vector database. In this vector database, we will store the some additional information which will help the LLM to get you information about a specific topic. The LLM may have some knowledge about the matter, but in case that ChatGPT, especially this 4 or the new models, they may have this information on the system, but when you go to very specific details about a topic, you need this additional information that for now we will load from a file. Which file I'm going to use is simply a research paper. I think I mentioned in some of the videos we worked before is Large Language Model as Zero Sum Reasoners. I recommend you to read it. It's giving you a context how LLMs are working and why all this the research and all the people who is putting a lot of effort in prompt engineering in order to help LLMs to provide better answers to the questions and or to the queries that you or the people is doing with the LLMs, no? And then we are not going to discuss what is the content, but well, it's just wanted to show you how you can do that, no? We import the libraries we need. Again, we will need the embeddings. We are going to use the embeddings of OpenAI. We will use a chain retriever QA from LangChain and the vector database Chroma. We also use a splitter, text splitter, recursive character splitter. We will go through now once we use it. Yeah, this is the document. We load the document with the text loader. This is one of the multiple loaders that had the LangChains. As I mentioned in the previous video, we had for text, CSV files, PDFs, HTML content, whatever probably you format you had, LangChain had a text loader. So if you remember what we discussed in the previous video, we need to transform this information into LangChain documents, and then the best way to do that is either using a text loader. This is just provide creating one document with the whole information, but in order this, as you may know, this is very long document. It's practically, if you divide by 5, probably 120 by 5 is 26,000 tokens in total. 24,000 tokens approximately, a little bit less probably, and then we will need to split the document in chunks. For that we will use the recursive character text splitter with a chunk size of 3,000. This is probably a little bit small for OpenAI, but well, it's just a matter if you want to extend the size of the chunk size. It's up to you. Well, we can try in any case for this experiment. We can put, for example, 800. And then we divide. Oops, sorry. Okay. And then now we have 19 documents and we produce 9 documents at an average of 6,388 characters. Now we create embeddings, again using OpenAI embeddings, and we load these embeddings in the Chroma vector database. Okay, so we take the first document, and again, as you remember from the previous video, or from previous I uploaded before, the LangChain documents essentially contains two main attributes. One is the page content. This is the text, in this case the chunk, the text that belong to the first chunks in which the document was splitted, and there is also metadata. Depending on which loader are you using, this metadata can be different. Usually it contains the path of the file, so in other cases, for example, when you work with pandas data frames, it contains the row and the file as well, the file path. Well, again, depending on the loader, it will contain more or less information. You can add additional information to this metadata, and this metadata later also can be used to narrow the search into the vector database. Then we create the retrieval QA chain, and we created the chain type is stuff. The retrieval we are going to use is the vector database and the LLM that we create. No? And then we ask yes, it's true. We need to reduce a little bit this because let's do it now. Probably we will need to let me restart the notebook, and once it's done we will continue. Okay, it's solved now. So we send a query to the QA system, and you can see here what the tool is answering. Well, I will say that is okay. Now here they are mentioning prompting. What we are going to do now is introduce a buffer, a conversation buffer memory, to keep track of the questions and the answers that the LLM is providing to us. We create a new template, and we create now the chain is slightly different. We just introduce the prompt and the memory, just to make aware the our LLM of what was the questions that we asked before. We answer again, yeah, and then on, yeah, I'm asking what is prompting in this context, and yeah. And now the last thing we will do is just introduce fresh information into the system. For example, this can be used in an online application that where you are updating some, I don't know, policies, procedures, and then you are creating a QA which is responding, and then some of the documents are updated. You can delete messages, or you can delete vectors from the database, and you can introduce as well, or add documents or vectors to the database. I'm going to use a book that I'm reading. I recommend you, by the way, to read this book. It's quite interesting. It's about the different steps or different techniques to work with the generative AI in AWS. And then, well, just take the book. This is a PDF. We use another text loader, a document loader in this case. And then this is just essentially the PDF, PI PDF loader. It's just taking the document and creating a LangChain document per page. The document is, you can see here, the page one. And then we have 300 new pages, and we add these pages to the Docker. Docker is the Chroma database. You can look at here a little bit of this. Oops, sorry, I miss it. Now where is that Docker split here? So here you see this is Docker is the Chroma data vector database, and now we simply add the documents, and now, for example, we can ask this, for example, how to tune a foundation model is not included in the research document I have wrote before, but this topic is included. No? And then we can ask now the QA tool how to do it. Again, this is just an example. We can connect the QA tool to multiple sources, even online sources, databases. We will cover all this stuff in next videos. I will upload where we cover other use cases and also agents and retrievers tools, etc. All the all the land chain ecosystem that we have available to in this wonderful library. And that's all. I hope you like it. And as I say, usually, if you like it, just hit me a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you. See you soon.